Hi, I'm Brad Neal with the University of Indianapolis. It's pretty much time to finish up talking about our different scenarios that we're concerned with for our reading. The final scenario that we're going to be considering is what happens when we now change the number of particles we have and see how that relates to a change in volume. So what's going to happen if we're going to hold pressure and temperature being constant? So we are trying to make sure at this point in time that our temperature is going to stay the same, our pressure is going to stay the same. The dependent variable is going to be the number of particles we've got. So we're starting with 50, we're going to increase that, and we're going to see what the volume of our container does to respond to the change of the number of particles. So here we go. So we're 50, and then, oh man, if we try to add 100 particles, the thing just like crashes on us. The pressure went up a little bit. Let's go ahead and let's reset that. This is kind of by design. What you hopefully saw was the container got really, really big. Just by doubling the number of particles we had, tried to make the volume of this container relatively huge, right? Let's try to add not double the number of particles, and let's maybe be able to show you a little bit easier the temperature and pressure being constant, what happens to volume. So let's go from 50 up to, 75, 76. Okay, so we've added that, and we didn't actually hold the pressure constant. Way to go, Brad, way to go. So let's put in our stuff, and then let's have the volume be the thing that changes. Temperature's been constant, pressure's been constant. Let's try this. 18th time is the charm. As we're adding in particles, notice what's happening to the volume. Volume's just getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So as the number of particles increases, if we want pressure and temperature to stay the same, the volume of our container has to increase. Kind of makes a little bit of sense. We're trying to keep the number of collisions on the sidewalls of the container to be always the same number of collisions, right? But if we're going to have more stuff in the container, we then have to make the walls of the container bigger so there's more space for the more things to be floating around so that the number of collisions remains constant. And we're also trying to not change the thermal energy of those particles, because we said temperature was being constant here as well. So that nicely goes along with the last of our gas laws that we're going to be talking about, and that's Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law has this nice relationship of a straight volume being directly proportional to our number of moles. If you wanted to go and play with this a little bit more, you could see what some of the other relationships are. If you change the number of particles, but you try to hold volume constant by chance, which you can see, and this is not Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law is what we just did. But if we give ourselves a number of particles here and we try to hold other things constant, you can play around with this and see what those other kinds of relationships are. For the purposes of this video, just to make it super clear, we're talking about Avogadro's law and volume being directly proportional to the number of moles. Okay, in the near future, we're then going to talk about what happens if we combine all of these principles, because volume, pressure, temperature, and the number of particles are all related to one another for any given gas. We could measure them for any given gas. So how are they related? We're going to address that in another video. Thanks.